Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity. Here I present Marriage of the Son, which is Matthew 22:1-14. And Jesus answered and spake unto them again by parables, and said, The royal kingdom of God is like unto a certain king. Here, royal king is God, which made a marriage for his son. Son is Christ Jesus. Eucharist is the celebration of marriage into which workers of God are invited to take part. Workers of God do not handle money and sent forth his servants, workers sealed to serve God only, to call them that were bidden to the wedding. Once-born people have no idea of the calling of God. So this invitation is to the twice-born people of spirit. And the first bidding was to the doubting twice-born people. They would not come because they loved this material world and its riches. Again he sent forth other servants, saying, Tell them which are bidden. Bidden mean twice born people. Behold, I have prepared my dinner, my oxen and my fatlings are killed, and all things are ready. Come unto the marriage. This invitation is to the twice born people of evil spirit, sealed to serve Satan than God. These are the hypocrites, and they understand the quality of food that God has for them, as the temple priest recognized Christ Jesus, but killed him. But they made light of it, and went their way, one to his farm, and another to his merchandise. And the remnant took his servants. Remnant mean the fanatic, and entreated them spitefully, and slew them, as Saint Stephen was killed. St. James the Just was killed by the fanatic. But when the king heard thereof, he was wroth, and he sent forth his armies, and destroyed those murderers, and burned up their city. This happened to Jerusalem in 70 AD, when it was destroyed mercilessly. Then saith he to his servants, The wedding is ready, but they which were bidden were not worthy. That means the Jerusalem people who were merciless, and they were not ready for this Eucharist. So the village people and all those people were invited. Go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as ye shall find, bid to the marriage. So those servants, they are the apostles who went to the Gentiles overseas as well, went out into the highways and gathered together all, as many as they found, both bad and good. And the wedding was furnished with guests. In the church of God, no one is forbidden, whether good or bad. And when the king, God, came in to see the guests, he saw there a man which had not on a wedding garment. This was Judas Iscariot, with money bag in his hand. You have to be 100% devoted to God when you enter the bridal chamber, the Eucharist of sacrifice and not of remembrance, as the hypocrites have propagated to mock Christ Jesus. And they don't mock John the Baptist so much. His baptism is taken twice in their lifetime. But Christ Jesus Eucharist is taken every week, once or twice, a great mocking. And he saith unto him, Friend, how comest thou in hither, not having a wedding garment? And he was speechless. Then said the king to the servants, Bind him hand and foot, and take him away, and cast him into outer darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Remember that Judas Iscariot was cast out of the company of 12 workers at the Last Supper, and he was told to go out in the darkness to do what he has in mind. For many are called, but few are chosen. There are many people who understand gospel, but they are not ready to put on the Christ. They are frightened of people. They don't want to be solitary. They want to stay in the group so that they earn the praises of men rather than of God. They mostly turn to be psychic. Many people understand the word of God, but very few have the courage to put it into practice to fight against the antichrists, such as Pope, dog-collared hirelings of Mammon, psychic televangelist, and whatnot. When you serve God, you should not expect any material reward, but the spiritual award, the gospel, the treasures. More you spend, more are given to you by our Father. Gospel is called a double-edged sword because it fights the hypocrisy of Antichrist. Hypocrites are psychics, seeking the praises of men by feeding them the sugar-coated tablets of falsehood that are sweeter than honey, but they kill people like the vipers kill. God bless you, and hope by this lecture will make some impact, and there will be some interest created. This is the age when you have people out of, say, 100, about 50%, more than 50%, they are once born. They don't want to know anything. They can't understand. The one which are understand are there are very few. They could be 10% hardly in the West. They understand the gospel, but they are frightened to put it into the practice, afraid of the praises of the men will be lost. So if you want, like politicians, they are the best example of psych. They would never say anything that will damage the number of votes they are having. So every word they utter from their mouth is well sugar-coated so that nobody can deny their supremacy. Same is televangelist. When they make speeches and other things, they are all pack of lies, all sugar-coated tablets. And there's no truth in their speech. In Jesus is the quality of your speech that count. That's what Jesus said. In Moses, what goes in, that counts, what food you eat, but it comes out. In Christ Jesus, what we hear with our ears and what comes out of your heart, that matters. So it's the quality in Jesus that matters. And in this dark age, how many people are interested in gospel, or how many people are brave enough to preach gospel? As St. Thomas said, 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. That means very few, because the one who is speaking the gospel, other people, he is solitary, he is not looking for the praises of men. So the other people who are, you know, thinking, hey, this man is just of his own, nobody follows him, nobody listens to him. He haven't got many gathering behind him, like these politicians and other, you see, televangelists. So then they don't follow you, and then the other people are warned. Only people who have ears to hear, they only come to him and listen and talk to him on round table terms. There's no imposition of views. In India, the last Christ Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji on earth, he was the anointed Christ representation of Satguru Nanak, and he said 1 in 10 million will understand or will preach gospel. So if you find people who are solitary, don't be frightened. God bless you.